Hi, I'm Kina McGregor, and today we're going to take a look at how to safely get into Hot Lotus Position. This is a posture that you want to practice patience over the long haul of your practice. If you rush the movement, the weakest joint will probably take a hit, which is your knee joint, and you can avoid that just by going nice and slow. Starting off in Dandasana position, you want to locate the head of the, as close to the head of the thigh bone as possible, which you can do by finding your trochanters, which are the bony part at the top of the thigh bone, and then you want to let the trochanter start off on the left side, drop back and down. Not because it's right, just because camera is closer to that angle. So when the trochanter drops back and down, you'll see that the knee points to the side. This is a new posture for you. You want to bring the foot in as close as possible, and you'll notice that the knee joint then closes. It's very important when you're working in half lotus position and you're new to the posture that you avoid any torque or twist in the knee. So if this is a new posture, you want to hold your knee and hold your foot and bring it slightly up and then pivot over, keeping the knee joint closed, using that external rotation. If your knee joint is off of the ground, you want to be very conscious not to actively squeeze the knee or to push it into the ground. Let it be. If you're feeling pain underneath the knee, you could take a block or a bolster or a towel and place it under your knee. But if it feels okay, let it be. Then, when you enter into half lotus position, you're more likely going to fold forward. And that folding forward motion is actually going to take your knee to the ground. When you exit the posture, you want to exit with the same amount of consciousness coming back to straight. If that was easy for you, there's another way to get into half lotus position that gives you even more external rotation. I'll show you that now. Take the knee out to the side, externally rotate your hip joint, then you bring your foot on top of the knee. The notion here is that the knee joint is open, so you want to make sure that the hip is flexible enough to take this external rotation. Then, you bring the foot and the knee all the way into the chest, feeling the external rotation of your hip joint, and then follow that external spiral to end into lotus position. You'll notice, if you compare the two, that this is a deeper lotus position. The calf muscle is spreading away from the thigh, and the knee is more easily to the ground. You'll also notice that the heel of the leg that's in half lotus position is closer into the pelvis. When you fold forward, this is an instant reaction or an instant reminder to lift up and over that half lotus position, getting you deeper into a forward bend. If you combine these two motions, you'll be able to protect your knee joint and safely externally rotate into a half lotus position.